بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. Dear respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to our brand new episode of the program entitled Towards the Origin. Our today's topic for discussion is Be Optimistic. Negativity and pessimism today engulf all of us one way or another. Each and every one of us today we see in the world in one form or other. We face different sort of calamities, challenges, have dealt with it, experienced with it. Some may be in the present, some are in the past. So as Muslims, how do we deal with it? What does the Quran teach us about being optimistic? What were the traits of our noble Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? All of this and many more, inshallah, we will be finding out in our today's program. But in order to do this, we have with us a very renowned scholar. He is the first British Bangladeshi who is the Imaam Khateeb of the Regent's Park Mosque, famously known as London Central Mosque. He is the graduate of Al-Azhar University, Fadilatul Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
First of all, thank you very much again, once again, for being so late here in the studio with us.
Barakallahu feekum. Thank you very much for organizing this very auspicious and beneficial program.
All pleasure is mine. Dear viewers, it's a live interactive program where you will be able to participate, engage, discuss with us. In order to do this, in a few while you will see our telephone number appearing at the bottom of your TV screen. But for your convenience, our telephone number is 0208-523-4111. And please feel free to ask any questions related to the topic. Sheikh, as I've introduced, our today's topic for discussion is be optimistic. Now, especially this week, when everyone is waking up to a very unique sort of news, different sort of news, especially Muslims are very distressed. Some are very fearful, scared, or even when we look at the social media, people are very, very worried. Now, out of all of this that's there, it's been happening for some time, future challenges that we might face, as Muslims, what should our role be? And can we still be optimistic after all of this that's happening in the world today?
Good question. Inshallah, we'll elaborate on this topic, inshallah, in details tonight. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wal'aqibatu lil-muttaqeen, was-salatu was-salamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal-mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammad ibn Abdillahi, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin, ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم ما بعد, I testify that there's none worthy of worship except Allah, and I testify that Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, is the slave and final messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The topic of our discussion tonight is optimism, positivity. I think and I believe it is a very, very important topic that we need to remind ourselves, we need to educate ourselves. Now, as for human beings, we are all human beings. Our lives are full of difficulties, problems, tests, trials and tribulations, calamities, masaib. So our lives is a pattern. We have different phases. Sometimes we're happy, other times we are upset. Sometimes we're laughing, and there are times we are crying. So we have got these pattern ups and down in our life. So life is, it has a lot of problems, it has a lot of difficulties. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent us to this world in order to test us. So He says in Surah Al-Mulk, خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created death and life in order to test us which one of us is best in terms of good deeds. خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he clarified, He made it clear that this life is test. It's a life full of problems and difficulties. Now, a true Muslim, a true believer, a true human being should be ready to welcome these challenges, difficulties and problems with a smiley face. And that is the teaching of Allah, the Almighty, teaching of our Prophet Muhammad, salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi. A Muslim is by nature is hardworking, sacrificing. He is ready to go through the hardship. Look at the beautiful ayah of the Holy Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. We have created human beings from the difficulties, الْمَشَقَّ وَالصُّعُوبَ. Human beings were created to go through these difficulties, to go through these challenges. So لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ أي مِنَ الْمَشَقَّةِ وَالصُّعُوبَةِ. Yes, the trials and tribulations of this world, the masaib والشدائد والمحن, the difficulties in this world, it worry us, it makes us worried, they make us anxious, at times they even make us feared about the problems and situations. And by nature, human beings, they do feel, because we are human beings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, with regards to this matter, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ هَلُوعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the human beings from hala. Hala is, it means the worry, the fear, the phobia. So the human beings have this kind of feelings, emotions of worry, emotions of anxiety, emotions of being scared at times. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ هَلُوعًا. So this is the nature of human beings. But anything, إِذَا زَادَ الشَّيْعًا حَدِّهِ إِنْقَلَبَ إِلَى ضِدِّهِ. There's a beautiful Arabic saying that if anything becomes excessive, that it becomes a problem and it becomes harmful. An excessive worry, excessive negativity, and pessimism is something discarded and rejected in our religion. So before I proceed, I quickly want to maybe define or give the meaning of the word optimism. Some of us, we might think, what is optimism? What is the meaning of the word optimism? So according to Cambridge Dictionary, it says, the meaning of optimism is hopefulness and confidence about the future or the success of something. So being confident, being positive about the future events, and that is optimism. And the word opposite to optimism is the pessimism. And it says that a tendency to see the worst aspect of things or believe that the worst will happen. So a person always thinks, oh, negative, something bad will happen, will never be successful, will never succeed, will never be able to do anything, will never be able to produce anything. So that kind of mentality or that kind of thoughts are part of pessimism. So optimism is something highly encouraged and motivated in our religion.
I had a question there. Now, sometimes we do notice a lack of confidence within ourselves. Does it not help us in developing the feeling of being pessimistic rather than being optimistic?
Yes. So therefore, when we look at the traditions of Prophet Muhammad, the text from the Holy Quran, the text from Hadith, we understand, you know, the science of psychology, it covers this aspect quite highly. But when we look at the Holy Quran, when we look at our religion, we have profound teachings regarding being optimistic and positive in our life. So confidence is very, very important. Jazakallah for the reminder. I wanted to say that being optimistic is the root of all success. Mm-hmm. Positivity, being positive in life, in general, as an individual, as a member of society, as a part of community, being positive is the root of all success, and being pessimist or negative is the root of all the failures. And this is something really important. So we have to have the sense of confidence. I would like to also refer you to some of the two hadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi. When we look at our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no one can have more tests and tribulations than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Indeed,
almost all sons passed away. Was raised as an orphan. Father passed away, then mother passed away, then grandfather, then uncle. So he was orphan and he was raised in that kind of sad and difficult situation. Yet Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was happy, positive, and he was optimistic in every situation, whether in war or in peace, whether in battle, whether in thirst or in normal conditions. You name and you see Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was very, very optimistic. And I would like to mention a hadith that every one of us, try and listen to this hadith carefully and properly. Now, this hadith is mentioned in Sahih in al-Bukhari on the authority of Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. Where Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu says, قَالَ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولَ That I have heard from Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam saying that لَا طِيرَةَ No, there is no divination. Now, طِيرَة was a method of judging or finding out someone's luck and fortune at the time of Jahiliyyah. So what the desert Arabs or the people at that time, what they would do, they would bring a bird and they would send the bird. If the bird would go towards the right, then they're lucky and they have the good fortune. And if the bird goes towards the left, then they have bad luck and they have bad fortune. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, La tirata, no divination in Islam. It was rejected in Islam. But then he says, وَخَيْرُهَا الْفَأْلِ And the best of it, and best thing is the fa'al. And then Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they asked, what is fa'al? وَمَا الْفَأْلِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ قَالْ وَمَا الْفَأْلِ قَالْ أَلْكَلِمَةُ الصَّالِحَةِ يَسْمَعُهَا أَحَدُكُمْ So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a good word that one of you hears. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he rejected finding out in such a way that you send a bird, if it goes towards the right, then you have good luck. If it goes towards the towards the left, then you have bad luck. And we have these kind of things, even these kind of natures still exist in our societies. In some of the Muslim world, I used to hear when I was young that if certain birds, tweet in certain ways, then the musibah or the bad things will happen. And that's how some of our elderly people, they still have this kind of beliefs. Of course, these are like not from Quran or Hadith of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
So basically, we do notice in our backgrounds that a lot of superstitions, is that the correct word to use?
Superstitions, yes.
Might not be directly with the forms of Islam, but somehow it might have been culturally influenced.
Absolutely correct. Yes,
so
that's right.
How do we make sure and distinguish between an element of superstition and element of haqq?
Some of the things are quite obvious and apparent. So when we look into it, if someone has a minimum level of or standard of knowledge, minimum understanding of the religion, they can easily identify what is actually can be correct and authentic and genuine. Generally, seeking knowledge and enhancing the understanding can always solve these kind of problems. Coming back to hadith of our Prophet Muhammad salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi, he says that la tirata, so no divination, but the best thing is the good words, the positive words, giving hope to people. You know, there's no rooms for negativity in our religion. So he says, Al-Kalimatu Saliha, a beautiful word, a kind word. This can heal. This can be a source of confidence, a source of hope in many people's lives. So he says, Al-Kalimatu Saliha, Yasma'uha Ahadukum. And also another hadith recorded by Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, and he says that, An Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, on the authority of Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, that Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, La adwa wa la tirata. There is not any transitive disease. Meaning at that time, and even some people up until today, they believe that if a disease comes to one person, then that will pass into the next person. And so that's how they become worried and they have fear. And some people, they still have this belief. And at that time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, some people used to have the belief of, a transitive disease. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, there is no transitive disease because the person, the one who gives the disease is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We may have a patient, we may have a person ill and unwell for many, many years in a house, but it doesn't mean that someone else will become ill because of that person. So transitive disease, that kind of beliefs, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam rejected. And also he said, no divination. Divination meaning the way to identify the good fortune or good luck. Sometimes people go to some people, some fortune tellers, and they ask If you can tell me whether I'm successful or I have a bad luck or a good luck, all those things, as you have mentioned, superstitions, and most of the times they guess and they predict, and at times they even lie. So it is very important to avoid those kind of things. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, but good omen pleases me. The good omen, al-fa'al, meaning good words, positive words, being positive, being optimistic, that kind of things pleases me. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, these kind of things make me happy. The good word, al-kalimatu al-tayyiba. Now, you have mentioned earlier, Brother Qamar, that the political situation, climate, we have seen in the region huge changes taking place, especially the changes in the United States of America, also post-Brexit era in Britain. Many Muslims are worried, and Muslims, I can see, and many of us, we have become very negative, and we're kind of losing the confidence ourselves. Yeah,
you're very right. Not only that, there's an element of fear instilled within us.
Absolutely correct.
That we have been somehow put into this sort of negative thought that the future
of the Muslim is bad
or going towards the disaster.
Yes, yes.
So how do we combat this?
I believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in a verse in the Holy Quran, "Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun." We have revealed this doctrine. We have revealed this Sharia. We have revealed these revelations, the Holy Quran, and the responsibility of preservation is in our hands. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will preserve this religion, which doesn't mean that we do not do anything. We have no responsibilities. We don't try. We don't put efforts to change the circumstance and situation. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to have firm faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah the Almighty will take care of us. Allah the Almighty will take care of Islam. He will take care of his religion. But we Muslims have to work, and we have to act, and we have to do our bits. And then inshallah we'll see the better result. Now, with regards to the worrying condition, situation, that many of us have become pessimistic, that all things are happening, Muslims are losing everywhere, Muslims are being marginalized, persecuted in many, many places. So the situation of the Ummah in general, yes, it is bad. And some people, they try to use the situation and say, oh, so we can't really follow Islam at this time. So it is quite impossible for us to practice the religion. And many Muslims I've heard, they're saying, even Islam, it doesn't suit, and it's not fit for this time and era, because it's too old and it's not suitable for this time. So people say these things, but look at the Holy Quran. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does he say? He says in a verse, إِن يَمْسَسْكُمْ قَرْحٌ فَقَدْ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْحٌ مِثْلُ وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. Listen to this verse very carefully. He says, good days and bad days are given to the nations, given to the men by turns. وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا. Every nation, they have their good days and they have their bad days. Every human being, every individual, we have our good days and we have our bad days. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, and he made a sunnah and tradition by saying, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. Good days and bad days are given to man by turns, that Allah may test those who believe. وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. Muslims believe in fate, and that is a fundamental issue. And we repeat again and again, fate is a fundamental issue. And so a Muslim is always positive and optimistic. Why? Because Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in a hadith, al-mu'minu al-qawi khayrun wa ahabbu ila Allah min al-mu'min al-da'if. A strong, physically, mentally, spiritually believer, a strong believer is better than a weak believer. A strong believer is better than and more beloved to Allah than a weak believer. Wa fi kullin khayr. However, in every one of them is good. We can't be negative. Every Muslim has good in them. Yeah. And then he said, "Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk." That be careful. Be try and benefit from the things that will be beneficial to you. So leave the things that is not beneficial. A lot of us, we engage in things that are not really beneficial to us.
Now, the element of strong and weak here is the definition to each of us, could be different. Now, the person who people would consider to be weak, might himself consider himself to be strong.
Exactly.
And the second element to it would be, how do you define someone? Because many people might perceive it in a negative manner when it says strong. Is it strongness in words, strongness in faith?
No, al-mu'min al-qawi, as I have mentioned, a believer spiritually, physically, because a strong person physically can benefit a lot. And Islam highly encourages people to stay fit, you know, to be strong, because a person who's active, who's well, he can benefit and he can serve his religion more than the one who's weaker. So in everything, generally, a strong believer is better than a weak believer. However, never be hopeless. Never think that you cannot do it. Never have that mentality that, oh, I won't be able to do. But seek help from Allah. وَلَا تَعْجَزْ وَإِنْ أَصَابَكَ شَيْءٍ. If anything afflicted you, if any musibah came to you, then don't say, oh, if only I did this, if only لَوْ أَنِّي فَعَلْتُ كَذَا وَكَذَا, if only I did that, which is a very well-known, common behavior or habit in many of our people, in our community. They say anything that bad happens, say, oh, if only I didn't go to that place. If only I didn't do that. So they keep on saying if, which leads to most of the fightings and quarreling and problems in a family, in a society, because of the if.
That's very true. Now, there's the other side to this coin is, people might say, from our viewers' perspective, that I do pray 5 times a day, I go to Hajj, I do fast in the blessed month of Ramadan, yet constantly one calamity after another I have to face.
Yeah.
Now, how does he understand?
This is very normal, because, as I have said, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most beloved. No one can claim to be better worshipper than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said that أكثر الناس ابتلاءً الأنبياء, the most people who go through the severe or the most difficult type of tests in this world are the anbiya, prophets. Then ثم الأمثل فالأمثل, then the ones below prophets, and then the ones below them. So that's how it works. A believer is tested according to his faith. So never say, you know, if only I did this, if only I did that. Never say that, because and say قدر الله ما شاء فعل. Say, you know, this was the decision of Allah and it's meant to happen. This is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the word if opens the door of shaitan. If opens the door of shaitan. And we have seen that practically when people start discussing about something they don't even know why it happened, if it's only in the hands of Allah and in his ilm, in his knowledge. But people, if, and which takes, you know, makes a lot of problems.
Jazakallah khair, Shaykh, for that. We'll be going for a quick break, inshallah. And then when we come back, inshallah, we'll be discussing it further and taking on
barak
more, to understanding more
Allah
this topic.
Barak, jazakallah khairan.
My dear viewers, in the first segment, we have touched upon the definition of optimism, and we have heard and listened to various ahadith, the Quranic verses, how we should respond to the challenges and the negativity that is there in the society that we live in. And one of the greatest hadith, which the Shaykh has quoted, that a strong believer is more dearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the weak believer. We'll continue our discussion, inshallah, after a short break. We'll see you then. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to our final segment, Towards the Origin. And our today's topic for discussion, be optimistic. Before the break, we did listen to the definition of what the optimism is all about and how we should refrain ourselves from being pessimistic and our negative thoughts. We'll be continuing our discussion today. But before that, I've been told there's a caller who has been waiting in the line for quite a while. We'll take his call and then, inshallah, we'll continue the discussion. So, caller, assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, caller. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Jazakallah khair for your phone call. Yes, what's your question?
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
First of all, I would like to say that the program is very useful, mashallah. We are benefiting a lot from the Sheikh's beautiful words.
JazakAllah khair for that.
My question was, sir, that I mean, why does the iman go up and down? Why does it fluctuate? I mean, because does this only happen to weak people? For example, did the Sahabi, the Sahaba, go through ups and downs in their iman? For example, like, why is it that in this day and age, that in the 21st century, that our iman goes up and down?
Right.
Like, I can't imagine, for example, the Sahabi, the Sahaba going through these stages.
Okay, I've got your question, inshallah. I'll be asking that question to the Sheikh, and inshallah he will be responding to your beautiful question that you have raised. It's a very beautiful point that our brother has raised there. The level of iman fluctuates, and we do know that.
Yes, yes.
And if I take it further from the brother's question, we do notice in the blessed month of Ramadan, when we're into the Ramadan, the level of iman boosts up.
Yep.
Then we do notice the change as soon as the Ramadan ends.
Absolutely.
So there is an element that we do feel it as a human being. So how do we combat this?
First of all, as human beings, we have an important element in our body, and that is called qalb.
Heart.
Qalb, heart. And the word qalb came from taqallub, which means constantly changing. Taqallub, taqallub. So constantly changing. So we are on a constant change, and that's something that we cannot reject and we cannot deny. And as brother mentioned about the Sahaba, even some of the Sahaba, they used to come to Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and they used to say, "O Prophet of Allah, the way we feel next to you when we are near you, we don't feel like that when we go home. So why does that happen?" So Prophet sallallahu alayhi said, "As-sa'a was-sa'a, it is time for this and it is time for that." So every one of us, we go through these changes, and this is natural. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. If the ayah of Allah, if the Quranic verses, if the dhikr of Allah is mentioned in front of them, then the iman goes up. So iman goes up and down. This is a belief of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This is the faith or belief of the Sunni Muslims.
So what does one do to make sure his level of iman is maintained and constant?
Absolutely, yes. Very important, especially when we live in a society where the society is completely opposite to what we want.
Challenges are there.
Yeah, challenges are there. So at that point, I say we have to stay in the company of good people as much as possible. In the environment of mosque, in the environment of good people, having good friends, having pious spiritual friends who can help us to boost our iman, who can help us to keep our iman on a good and average level, or in the highest level. So these are the things can be done.
Jazakallah khair for that answer, Sheikh. My dear viewers, if you have similar questions or questions related to the topic, please feel free to dial the telephone number that is appearing at the bottom of your TV screen, 0208 523 4111, and our guests will be more than happy to answer your questions. Now, Sheikh, coming back to our discussion, and our topic is being optimistic. But we did discuss, and one element I wanted to discuss with you, that today as Muslims, we feel the weakness in every sector that we're involved in.
Yep.
Like, for an instance, we don't want to pray, or we're scared of wearing hijab, or those that are keeping sporting beard in public places, in case we might be victimized or we might be assaulted, things like that.
Beautiful question.
How do we combat this?
Yes, beautiful question. We have kind of lost our confidence, himma. That himma that Muslim used to have. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had the best, highest himma. Sahaba radiallahu anhu, that's the highest himma, the courage. We lost the courage as Muslims, and therefore,
why is that, do you think?
We have seen that there are Muslims that try to hide their identity as Muslims.
Correct.
They try to hide the as much as possible that they're Muslims. So there's lack of confidence, inferiority complex, there's negativity, negative thoughts, there's down feeling, and that needs to be dealt, and that needs to be addressed. I believe that when we look at the Muslim Ummah, the Muslim world, we see Muslim world. There's a lot of failures, and we must address and we must discuss amongst ourselves that we have weaknesses. We fail in many, many ways at this time. However, that is not the end of the world. And as I said, everyone has their good days and everyone has their bad days.
Correct.
Look at a beautiful verse from the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. When Sayyidina Yaqub, Prophet Jacob, when he sent his sons to Yusuf to inquire about Yusuf alayhi salam, so he said, "Oh my sons, go and inquire about Yusuf and his brother." and never give up hope of Allah's mercy. No, never be hopeless, never despair. لا تيأسوا من روح الله. Certainly no one despairs, no one become hopeless of Allah's mercy except those who disbelieve. So إنه لا يأس من روح الله إلا القوم الكافرون. No matter how much weaknesses we may have, how much failure we may have, we have good things, and I must agree, we must admit that we have a lot of good things as Muslims, alhamdulillah, even up until today. But it is not as it was in the history, the beautiful, glorious history of the Muslim. It's not as it was. However, we still have to have, we can't be hopeless. We still have a lot of good things. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرُونَ. So, very important that we remain optimistic and we remain positive, inshallah.
Now, does it mean that as Muslims, we lead our life between the balance of hope and fear?
Exactly. So that's the word taqwa. Taqwa means بين الخوف والرجاء, which means the word taqwa, when we hear again and again, this means the remaining and staying in between hope and fear. So belief of the Muslim, Sunni Muslim, Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, is that we fear Allah while we are hopeful. And belief of a sect in Islam called Al-Khawarij, it was based on fear only.
Okay.
So everything would depend on the fear. So therefore they would make a lot of things haram based on fear.
Okay.
Just because they think it can be a sin, so they make haram. And there's another sect called Al-Murji'ah. They used to base their beliefs and faith on hope. So everything's about hope. We have people in our society that say, oh, don't worry, Allah is kind. You don't have to pray. You know, even if you don't pray, Allah will forgive.
That's very true. If I add that bit a little bit, a lot of people would add into it, well, I have the intention of doing good deeds.
Yeah.
Now, how do you respond to those kind of things? That I have the intention, yes, but I don't have the amal with it.
No, so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat.
That's the hadith.
Actions of human beings are judged according to intention. No intention can be counted without action. So actions are parts and parcel of intention. Now also, Brother Qamar, we also see there are people in our society, those who couldn't do enough for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So probably they had a time when they couldn't worship Allah. They couldn't observe the commandments of Allah.
Just to clarify, when you say not enough, is it means that they were involved in ma'siyah, in haram activities, or did not fulfill the obligations of the teaching of Islam?
Yeah, we see people are coming sometimes to our mosques and to many imams come and saying, Brother Imam, we have committed so much sins in our life. We have committed some really severe kind of sins. Are we going to be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Mm-hmm. Is there any hope? But we always remind to people, and we always remind ourselves by saying the ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O my slaves, those who have transgressed, those who have committed sins excessively, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Never be despair. Never be hopeless from the mercy of Allah. Never think that Allah will not forgive, because Allah is غفور. He is most forgiving. غفور is على وزن فعول. كثير الغفران. A lot of غفران. A lot of forgiving. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is غفور الرحيم. So He forgives and He loves forgiving people. And we have that whole chapter in our Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kind and He forgives people.
But there's an element to this as well. Many would say that if He forgives, then why does He punish?
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives chances to people.
Okay.
He gives enough time in this world. We get 40 years, 50 years, 60 years, and sometimes maybe 90 years. And my grandmother lived for more than 100 years. Yes, so we have enough time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us chances over and over. And then when we still are neglectful, when we're still heedless, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's a limit to everything.
Correct.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get us on these kind of negligences. Before our time runs out, previously you've mentioned about the optimist, being optimistic with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how does one become optimistic with Allah? Like, how do we become positive with Allah? So many of us, I have heard Muslims saying, and even some non-Muslims probably saying, why does God do this to me? You know, Allah, why does he's not just, he's not fair. you know, people make those kind of comments, أعوذ بالله. But look at Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he says, حسن الظن بالله من حسن العبادة. Having positive thoughts about Allah, being optimistic about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is part of an important part of well-conducted worship. So husn al-ibadah, it has an important part, which is the good thoughts about Allah. And also, human beings, we have to be positive with human beings. Sometimes when we have a person who is ill for a long time, people start saying in our society, oh, you know, we'll never get better. We listen, আমরা অনেক মানুষ এখন যে ইবুয়ার বালা হইত না জীবনে এই মানুষ আর জীবনে আর তারা বেমার হন তো নাই তো আল্লাহ তারা বালা পাইছেন না তো উই সি দিস কাইন্ড অফ থিংস পিপল মেক কমেন্টস নেগেটিভ কমেন্টস অ্যাবাউট পিপল দ্য পেশেন্টস বাট লুক অ্যাট আওয়ার প্রফেট সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ওয়েন হি ভিজিটেড এ ডেজার্ট আরব এ বেডুইন ম্যান অ্যান্ড হি ইউজড টু লাভ ভিজিটিং দ্য সিক পিপল অ্যান্ড ওয়েন হি ভিজিটেড হিম হোয়াট ডিড হি সে হি সেড লা বাসা তাহুরুন ইনশাআল্লাহ ওয়েন হি ভিজিটেড দ্য ডেজার্ট আরব হি সেড La bas, nothing to worry. There's no harm, no harm. Tahur, inshallah, you'll be purified from your sins. Look at the positive thoughts, positive hope that he gave to that desert Arab or the patient. And that's a sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When we visit someone who's unwell, we say, La bas, tahur, inshallah. What does that mean? Positive.
Now, that's very true. And to add a little bit that we see in the society, just to add a little bit, that when we see someone who we dislike, someone we have some sort of rivals, we then associate, because he did this to me, that's why Allah has punished him with giving him ill health.
That's right.
Or financially, he got destroyed.
This is a belief.
Now, how true is this belief?
I think this is a sickness that many of us have, and we really connect and always link up things with other things. Oh, just because you had an argument with somebody in the morning, and in the evening something bad happened. Oh, because you did this to me, that's what happened to you.
That's true.
No, we don't know the ilm al-ghayb. This is all the knowledge of unseen. If someone's saying that and claiming, then as if he's trying to claim that he knows the ilm al-ghayb.
And that's the biggest sin.
That's a very big, dangerous matter. So we have to always remain and say, no, we don't know everything why happens. We know things are happening, but Correct. We don't know why it happens. And a lot of our problems rooted to finding the causes. When we look for the causes, then we get into a problem. And I can give you the example of black magic. So if someone is, for example, affected by black magic, then people in our society start assuming, oh, probably that person did. Or my mother-in-law did, my father-in-law did, or that person. So people start assuming and accusing, and that kind of negative thought needs to be avoided in our society.
That's
and especially when it comes to these kind of black magics and...
No, এখানে কিন্তু আরেকটা জিনিস আমি অ্যাড করতে হয় যে আমাদের শাশুড়িরা বা বউরা এখানে কিন্তু একটা কমেন্ট করে ফেলেন যে উইদাউট ডিলিং উইথ মেডিকেল ইলনেস সবসময় অ্যাসিউম করেন যে হয়তো কেউ জাদুটনা করেছে
Yes, yes. That's also there. মানুষ মনে করেন যে আমরা মধ্যে অনেক আছে যে মনে করেন কোনো একটা বেমারে আসলে অনেক সময় আমরা ইনশাল্লাহ উই ক্যান ডিসকাস দ্যাট ম্যাটার অন এ সেপারেট ইস্যু সেপারেট প্রোগ্রাম the dealing with illnesses, how we can deal with illnesses and how we normally muddle up and we mix up things. Before we come to the end, I want to mention a hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I mentioned earlier, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the most difficulties in his life. And we know that. He was the most responsible. Is there anybody who has more responsibility than Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? A man who influenced most influential man in the history of humanity. Yet Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his wife Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha was asked about his character. So Amra bint Abdul Rahman, she asked Sayyida Aisha, "O Aisha, how does Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam behave idha khala? When he becomes by himself, when he becomes alone, when he's with family, what does he do? What's his characteristic?" So she said, "Kana abarra an-nas." He was the best of human beings. أَبَرَّ النَّاسِ وَأَكْرَمَ النَّاسِ And he used to be most generous and kind human being. ضَحَّاكًا He used to have sense of humor. Jolly. بَسَّامًا He used to be smiling at all times. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to smile at all times. This is known in the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now many of our people, they think, oh, being sign of piety or sign of being religious, being gloomy, being harsh, being unhappy, they think that the sign of being spiritual is these kind of things. But when we look at Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kana bassaman. What does bassam mean? Kathir al basma, kathir al tabassum. Bassam again, ala wazn fa'al. It's an important thing. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to have sense of humor. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah said, ya sahib al-hammi, inna al-hamma munfarijun. He said in a beautiful poem that, ya sahib al-hammi, O person of worry, O person of grief and anxiety, inna al-hamma munfarijun. Don't forget that anxiety, worry will fade away. Inna al-hamma munfarijun. Abshir bi khayrin fa inna al-farij Allahu. Be happy. Be happy. Stay positive. Be optimistic, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who removes, He is the remover of all the stress, anxiety, and negativity. So very important for us to stay positive in every situation in our life.
That's very, very true. Now, you did mention about how Rasulullah always had the good sense of humor.
Allahu Akbar, yes.
And he was always smiley. He was always very kind and with happiness, with a positive outlook, he used to deal with the challenges that he had. Now, we have an understanding, if you're religious, you have to always look serious, talk serious, and the element of replying with a smile back,
yes,
is most of the time absent.
I think,
how do we
when
deal
Prophet
with
Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that word, it really is very effective when he says, kalimatu tayyiba, a beautiful word, a kind word. This can be charity. This can change a person's complete state, the mood. And very, very important, the kalimatu tayyiba, a beautiful, a kind word. We need to find the ways, especially the good words, positive and thoughts, in order to remove this kind of problems.
Okay.
Just wanted to mention also that few examples of the negative thoughts in our people, generally amongst the Muslims. Number one, some people say that Islam will not flourish because of the condition that we see. Islam will not go forward. This is wrong. We can never think like that. Islam is always will flourish. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us. He's seeing us how we act towards, you know, these kind of situations. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will take care of our religion. Sometimes we have in our community, people are negative from day one, from the beginning. When they see somebody, they make negative comments. When they see a alim or a scholar or an imam, they make negative comments.
To add a little bit further, not only an alim, if we see anyone who is successful,
yeah,
we add a comment to it, as if that there's some sort of element of jealousy involved there.
Yes, yes. So jealousy can be a cause of also negativity, being negative.
I see.
So jealousy can need to be dealt. It's a separate problem. And that's a huge problem in many of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.
Ameen.
So negative thoughts about other people, very bad. Sometimes maybe one of our friends or family member is not visiting me. So we start thinking, oh, probably he doesn't like me anymore, or she doesn't like me anymore. But we do not know what is going on, what can happen, what's happening. And so we make comments and become negative. Also, sometimes when people have illnesses, we make negative comments. And we make the person more ill even, when we make negative comments. So we have to stay positive, as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. We also have a negative thoughts between the elders and youth, especially in our masajid, in our mosques. So when we go to the mosque, we see the elders are saying, oh, these are youngsters. They do not know much. They're like young. And the youngsters are saying, oh, these are elders, chacha, uncles. They don't know much.
Backward thinking.
But we have to respect one another. Elders need to be compassionate to youngers, and youngers need to be respectful towards elders.
So
every one of them has good.
The bridge between the two generations.
There has to be. And I have seen that in our youth, in our youngsters, they're always, or mostly, they're making negative comments about the uncles. And I understand the uncles, they may have some sort of reservations, as we do as well, as youngsters. But that doesn't mean that we have negative thoughts all the time, because they're also producing a lot. We cannot become negative. We sometimes criticize the mosques, you know, although it's run by. But if our elders didn't make and build these mosques, we wouldn't be able to pray as youngsters today.
Indeed.
So they have done a lot. So we always have to look at the positive things. There are negative sides as well. But as Muslims, we always look at the positive sides. Also, sometimes we make negative comments to our children. Very, very important. A negative comment can destroy the future of a child. So when you say you will never become anything, we have heard people are saying to their children, that parents are saying to the children, because they failed one exam, or maybe like they couldn't get the mark desired standard. So the parents say, oh, you are a failure. You can never do anything. This can destroy the future of a child. So you have to always encourage them, motivate them, make them positive and hopeful, because being hopeless, being negative is the beginning of all the problems.
Yeah, there's another element to it. If a parents have got 3 or 4 offspring, yeah, and just unfortunately one of them may not be academically brilliant
than the, and like
he's ashamed, he's put down in front of other siblings, what impact will that child have, and especially in his childhood, see, the psychology, the impact that he has to go through?
Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never ever belittled anybody, any child,
regardless of the age.
Child, you know, children were even more beloved to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to love kissing children, he said. And even Hassan radiallahu anhu, they used to play with Prophet even while he was praying. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would never make, you cannot show me anywhere in the tradition of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he made negative comment or he belittled anybody in front of anyone. So we have to be very careful. Sometimes we think, oh, children, they're just children. We kind of become heedless about children. No, children, they are much more clever than many of us in many ways. So let's not, even a seven-year-old child, let's not neglect their talents. Let's not neglect their. So let's be positive and give them always encouragement. And this is the teaching of our religion, our Prophet Muhammad, salawat Rabbi wa salamu alayhi.
Jazakallah khairan. With this, we have come to the end of our today's program. Inshallah, I know there's a lot more to cover. Absolutely. And of course, time is always short in terms of when it comes to covering the whole element of the program. Thank you very much for being here with us in the studio. And inshallah, we hope to see you in next week as well.
May Allah bless you, Engineer Qamar. You, mashallah, you've done very well also.
Jazakallah.
I would like to also thank you for your support and for your help all the way through.
Barakallahu feek, barakallahu feek.
Barakallahu feekum.
With this, my dear viewers, we have come to the end of our today's program. Our discussion was, the topic that we have discussed is be optimistic. We have heard the treatment, we have heard the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, how was the embodiment of these traits, of these excellent traits and character. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable these sort of character, the character that he always had when it comes to calamities and challenges. He had a positive outlook with everything, being optimistic. Inshallah, our next week topic will be confidentiality. And we hope to see you then to discuss more in details with regards to confidentiality and how as Muslim we need to deal with this subject. Until we meet again, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.